Howdy, how's it going? My name's Davvy Chappy, and today it's time to ink some sweet tats and make a bunch of old people say, "You'll never get a job with those," because we're going to be talking about each of Eberron's magical Dragonmarked houses and their associated Dragonmarked tattoos. I'm going to go over who can get Dragonmarks, how they get them, what marks mean, and I'll be talking about the massive influence that each Dragonmarked house has over the continent of Corvair, and by extension, the entire world. As always, keep in mind that a lot of this is just my opinion, so if you feel like I'm too much of a nerd who doesn't understand the true art of tattoos, feel free to leave a comment down below. But with that out of the way, let's begin. So, a Dragonmark is a magical tattoo that acts as the physical representation of the will of the three primordial dragons via an ancient prophecy that Sybaris foretold, known as the Draconic Prophecy. In layman's terms, a Dragonmark is a telltale sign that history has its eyes on you, because these glow-in-the-dark birthmarks grant an innate magical power to the bearer, with the specific type of magic depending on which of the 13 Dragonmarks they have, and the strength of the magic depending on whether the Dragonmark is a least, lesser, greater, or even mythical Sybaris version of said Dragonmark. The 13 different Dragonmarks are passed down via 13 different bloodlines, with only a specific race able to bear each Dragonmark, and even then the chances of one appearing are rare and largely random. Each separate bloodline has formed a Dragonmarked house, and each house controls some form of service or trade in Corvair that corresponds with their mark's power. The 13 different Dragonmarks, along with their houses, are very numerous and a bit confusing, so you're gonna have to bear with me a second here, because they are as follows: the Mark of Making, bore by the humans of House Caineth, which runs the Fabricator and Tinker Guilds, and can use their mark to both mend and create items. The Mark of the Sentinel, bore by the humans of House Dinaith, which runs the Defenders and Blademarks Guilds, and can use their mark to gain protective spells. The Mark of Hospitality, bore by the halflings of House Galanda, which runs the Hostellers Guild and can use their mark to conveniently create food and lodgings for people. The Mark of Healing, bore by the halflings of House Durasco, which runs the Healers Guild and can use their mark to, I don't know, maybe heal? The Mark of Warding, bore by the dwarves of House Kundarak, which runs the Banking and Warding Guilds and can use their mark to warn you when there's a bitch incoming. The Mark of Storm, bore by the half-elves of House Lyrandar, which runs the Raincaller and Windrights Guilds and can use their mark to control the goddamn weather and slap people with the might of Zeus. The Mark of Detection, bore by the half-elves of House Medani, which runs the Warding Guild and can use their mark to sense hidden threats, such as invisible assassins or someone ripping major ass. The Mark of Passage, bore by the humans of House Orion, which runs the Courier and Transportation Guilds and can use their mark to walk through walls, disappear, and fly. The Mark of Shadow, bore by the elves of House Firulin, which runs the Entertainers and Artisans Guild and can use their mark to cast scrying spells, as well as illusions and other deceptive magics. Also, a challenger approaches in the form of House Thirani, which is a splinter group that broke off from House Firulin, making them bitter rival spy organizations. The Mark of Scribing, bore by the gnomes of House Civis, which runs the Speaker and Notaries Guilds and can use their mark to control words and writing, which I'm told is very useful. The Mark of Finding, a special dragon mark that is bore by the humans and half-orcs of House Therash, which runs the Finders Guild and can use its mark to find lost things such as runaway criminals, your TV remote, and my will to live. The Mark of Handling, bore by the humans of House Vidalis, which runs the Handlers Guild and can use its mark to breed superior animals by checking their secret IV rating. And finally, the Mark of Death, bore by the elves of House Vol, which got itself caught in the middle of a civil war between the dragons and the elves and decided that the best solution would be to interbreed by creating the first elf-dragon hybrids to show everyone that mutual peace was achievable. Both the elves and the dragons looked upon this horrid, elf-scaly, furry abomination, and to Vol's credit, they immediately made peace with each other, so they could murder the fuck out of both the abomination and the entire house that managed to create it. Good job, House Vol. And let that be a lesson to you all. Leave your weird slash fiction in your diaries where they belong, or else you'll end up causing world peace between warring nations when they realize that it was their own hubris that birthed something so horrid and disturbing. But moving back to the Dragonmarks, there were some people early on that realized that their Dragonmarks didn't correspond with any of the known houses, or just any other mark in general, and this caused some discourse in the greater tattoo community. It seemed that these aberrant dragon marks were created when dragon-marked creatures of different houses procreated, with a child bearing a highly volatile mark that wildly varied in both magical ability and overall power. The aberrant mark also had a chance of manifesting on races that could normally bear a pure dragon mark, which led to a lot of awkward moments as commoners would celebrate getting their free ticket into the good life, only to be told, "Wait, nope, wait a minute, yep. That's heresy," and subsequently being shunned by practically the entire world. The shunning actually went so far that sometime between the banishment of the Dalkeer and the formation of Gallifrey, all of the Dragonmarked bearers waged a huge war of extermination on the aberrant Dragonmarks. The war, aptly named the War of the Mark, is what inevitably solidified the houses as a presence in Corvair and pushed them to create a unified government unto themselves, ruled by a council known as the Twelve that would decide the rules and regulation for how Dragonmarked individuals are to behave in life. And speaking of war and unification, the Dragonmarked houses would see their greatest rise to power come to them, carried by a man named Gallifrey. See, when the OG King Gallifrey I was gathering all the countries to make his own super country, he enlisted the help of the Dragonmarked houses to assist him in his goals. Of course, given the potential in growing their power exponentially, and also the fact that Gallifrey had a huge, scary army, the choice was obvious. But King Gallifrey wasn't a fool, and he knew that he had to create regulations for the houses so that they would never become too powerful and subsequently subjugate his people. So in return for letting them stay super rich and powerful, the Dragonmarked houses were prevented from creating any formal army of their own, they were forbidden from claiming any land, and they could not marry into Gallifreyan aristocracy. With these rules set in place, the Kingdom of Gallifrey saw many generations of peace and prosperity alongside the Dragonmarked houses. Of course, all that flew out the window when the last war started up. Once Gallifrey splintered and became no more, the houses no longer had to abide by any deal, and so they all started playing fucking Monopoly with Corvair, and just like any game of Monopoly, everybody was a huge dick to the people who didn't have any money. In fact, at the end of the last war, feeling scorned and outcast by the rest of the magical birthmark community, the few remaining creatures with an aberrant Dragonmark said, "Screw you guys," and decided to create their own Dragonmarked house with blackjack and hookers. They named this house House Tarkanon, set up shop in the city of Sharn, and threw rocks and insults at anybody who arrived at their gates. Now, with the Treaty of Thronehold established, the Dragonmarked houses are in a very precarious place where they all seek to expand their power, but one wrong move will lead the world back into a full-scale war. But perhaps war is precisely what the Draconic prophecy calls for, and the bearers of the marks will lead Eberron into its true destiny. But that'll about do it. I hope you enjoyed this video, leave a like and comment if you did, subscribe if you want to be a cool dude, and maybe support me on Patreon so that I can slowly make my entire life revolve around D&D. Also, if you want to stay up to date on all of your Davvy news, I keep a link to my Discord and Twitter in the description below. But yeah, Davvy out.